Hello everyone. This is a vid about AuthorTube Story Tech, and I tell you three stories about toothbrushes and vibrators. The first one. I got a present at my birthday. I think it was my 22th birthday or maybe 23rd birthday, and it was an ugly yellow vibrator, and it stank horribly. This is what I remember about the thing. I unpacked it, and that's my last memory of it. I probably took it home, but then it just vanished. I knew that this vibrator will reappear in the most horrible situation possible. I waited for it to reappear, yeah? And I heard a few years nothing about it, but I moved out, but still had things stockpiled by them. So I thought, oh, maybe it reappears when I start moving and my grandpa helps me with moving, and this would be a great situation for it to reappear. But no, it didn't reappear. It never appeared in my new apartment. So I thought, okay, it has to be by my parents still. I moved back to my parents. And one day my mother said, Joanne, I found something. I think it's from you. It's a dildo. And I thought so, okay. The situation could have been much more embarrassing than my mother finding it. They said, yeah, I lost a vibrator, and good that you found it. He showed the dildo to me, and it was the travel case for my toothbrush. Good. It didn't reappear. In this story time tag, I have to tell what I learned as a writer about it. There is the concept of Chekhov's gun. This is when a gun is shown in scene one, then it has to go off during the story, preferably the climax. So I have this vibrating, yellow, stinking Chekhov's gun somewhere in my possessions, which is just waiting to go off. This is 15 years ago, so in the meantime, I'm looking forward to when and where it will go off. I still think it exists somewhere. I moved since that time 7 or 8 times, maybe a bit less. I'm still thinking, there's a yellow vibrator somewhere in my possessions. I just don't know where. Second story about toothbrushes and vibrators. I'm at my company, and a colleague, his name is Andy, explains to me and another colleague, his name is Orkan, some stuff, and we listen to him. I don't know why he opened his amenity pack, his cosmetic bag. I think because he wanted to fetch some ointment for some burn, and there was this thing in there. And it totally looked like a dildo. I looked over to Orkan, and he had exact the same facial expression I was feeling. Like, we don't judge. We don't judge. You can have in your amenity pack whatever you need to feel comfortable on journeys. And Andy caught our expressions and said, it's a toothbrush. And we, oh yes, yes, of course, a toothbrush. We never thought anything else. This was the second story. I learned something about it, but not for, I don't know, not for my author life maybe, but as a human being, that we sometimes try not to judge, even if there's nothing to judge. So I caught myself being judgmental without a reason. And this is something we should remember when we judge people, that we might not know the whole story. And even if we don't judge people and are very hard trying not to show that we judge people, or trying very hard not to judge people, it's always good to have it in the back of my mind. Oh, the situation might be totally different than the first glance suggests. The third story about toothbrushes and vibrators. I'm sorry, the title gives away most of the stories. I was on a health retreat. One of the other women said, oh, did you heard what happened? She was a great storyteller. She told me a joke about a parrot, and I'm still laughing about it. Yeah, what might be relevant to the backstory is that she is a lesbian. I don't know the stats, but I believe that lesbians own a vibrator at a higher percentage than heterosexual women. I don't know if this is true. Her roommate came to the cafeteria and said, Connie, your amenity pack is vibrating. Connie was horrified, went to her room, stopped it, and went back to the cafeteria and tried to convince everybody that it was a toothbrush. And of course I believe that it was a toothbrush, because yeah, the other three stories already happened, and I knew, yeah, it was a toothbrush. And she told this story that we are laughing our ass off. Then the crucial thing for me happened. So I sat there and had the choice to tell my vibrators and toothbrush stories, and I didn't, yeah? Because I thought there is a time to tell a story, and it's sometimes better not to tell a story. And I felt I would one up her if I told my toothbrush and vibrator stories. I don't told a story, and I think I learned something for life. I think this decision was totally good not to tell this story at this time. Yeah, maybe it's sometimes totally all right not to tell some stories. That was a shitty moral at the end of the story time tag. This were my three toothbrush and vibrator story. I tag the best-selling author and writing coach Liza Daly and RK Gold. I link them down in the description. And thank you for Sari Wright's books for tagging me after I begged her to do it, because I want to do another AuthorTube tag. So if you have a tag for me, please tag me, and I hope you enjoyed the stories, and please subscribe, like, and comment. See you next week. Bye-bye.